Welcome to LoadRunner Tutorial 5. In this video, we will understand one of the concepts to make our VUser script ready for load testing. This concept is called parameterization. It means instead of using a constant value in our VUser script, we can have a parameter. Different VUsers would use different values in the load test. So let us understand parameterization. Now this is the recorded VUser script. Now I'm going to replay it. When I replay my VUser script, it executes, and at the time of execution, it uses the constant values that are recorded in the VUser script. So now the VUser script execution is complete. I already have the HP WebTours web application open. And if I click on the itinerary button, we can see that it has made a flight reservation for March 30th, 2015. Now, where is this value coming from? It is coming from the data that is already present. So we can find that data. Let me find it. March 30th, 2015. So here is the value. What this means is that every time we replay this VUser script, it is going to make the flight reservation for exactly the same date. Obviously, this is not realistic. In order to make it realistic for different VUsers, we can have different dates. So let us see how we can implement the parameter. So first, we need to find this particular step in the step navigator. So I click on the step navigator. So it highlights that step. Right click on that step in the step navigator and click on show arguments. So here are all the arguments with their values. Now we are interested in depart date. So click on the ABC icon, and here I can give the name of the parameter. Let me call it RDate for reservation date. And click on the properties button. So here we can click on the create table. So it says it is going to create a new data file. So click OK. And it has picked up the value from the VUser script. Now we can change it also. So let us say I want one reservation to be made on April 1st. 2015. So I can enter that data. Let me add a couple more values. The second date I want to use is April 2, 2015. Add one more value. April 3, 2015. And click on the close button. And click on the OK button. Now here we see instead of the constant value, there is a parameter. Click on OK. So here, if we look in the editor window, we see for that particular value, there is a parameter. So it is the name of the parameter enclosed by curly braces. Now we also need to make sure that the same data is there in any other request also. So let me scroll to the top. Again, find that particular date. Click on find next. So there is one other request which uses this data. So I'm going to parameterize it. So the name of the parameter is RDate. And save our VUser script. Go to HP WebTours web application. Make sure that all the reservations are cleared. Now, the data for the reservation date is going to come from the DAT file. So I want to execute it three times so that it uses each of those values. So go to replay, runtime settings. And in runtime settings, we have the run logic. and here I'm going to give the number of iterations as 3. Save it and replay the vUser script. So now, instead of using the constant value from within the vUser script, VuGen is going to take the values from the dat file that we have created. So this is called parameterization. So we can have a number of realistic values specified for the parameter. So irrespective of whatever value was used at the time of recording, it is going to pick up those values one by one and use them in the replay. When we use the LoadRunner controller to execute our vUser script, the controller is also going to pick up the values from the parameter file that we have already given. This makes our vUser script data driven because we have separated the data from the vUser script. So now the playback is complete. So let us go to the HP Web Tours web application and look in the itinerary. So we see, as expected, there are 3 reservations. And the first reservation is for April 1, 2015, the value that we had specified. The second reservation is for April 2, 2015. And the last reservation is for April 3, 2015. So this is how we can parameterize our vUser script to make it more realistic. Thank you.